इन आवर प्रीवियस पीरियड ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स फ्रॉम चैप्टर 4 वी लर्न द अल्टीट्यूड ऑफ ट्रायंगल एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव लर्न प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ अल्टीट्यूड ऑफ ट्रायंगल. नाउ ऑन पेज नंबर 20 फ्रॉम एक्टिविटी फर्स्ट सेकेंड एंड थर्ड So, from these three activities, we can know that first important point, the orthocenter of right angle triangle is the vertex on the right angle. The orthocenter of an obtuse angle triangle is the exterior of the triangle, activity 2. And the orthocenter of an acute-angle triangle is in the interior of triangle, activity 3. Now, in this period, we are going to learn median of triangle. Now, we'll study the median of triangle. Suppose this is triangle ABC. Now see here, suppose this point P is the midpoint of side BC. Side BC is opposite to vertex A. The side opposite to vertex A is BC. And if I join vertex A and midpoint of BC, then I will get here segment AP. This segment AP, that means from vertex A, a segment is drawn. This segment is joined to the midpoint of BC. And this segment AP is called median of triangle ABC. That means the segment joining the vertex of a triangle and the midpoint of the side opposite to the vertex is called median of triangle. A segment joining the vertex and midpoint on the opposite side is called a median of triangle. Now we can draw two more medians because this triangle has three sides. So on each side, we can draw one median. Suppose Q is the midpoint here. So BQ is another median here. Suppose R is the midpoint of side AB. And RC is third median. Now see here, all three medians intersect in one point, and that point is denoted by letter G, and it is called the centroid. It is called the So point G is called the centroid of triangle. All the three medians of triangle are concurrent. That means they are passing through one point. Therefore they are concurrent. All three medians of triangle are congruent and their point of congruence is called centroid and it is denoted by G. Now this centroid divide each median into parts. Suppose median AP is divided into parts AG, GP. Median BQ is divided into parts BG, QG. Median CR is divided into parts CG, RG. Now I will find the relation between these two parts here. Now see here. Length of AG equal to 13. Length of GP is equal to 6.5. Now we will take the ratio. AG is to GP. That means 13 upon 6.2. 6.5. That is equal to 130 upon, or that is equal to 2 upon 1. That is, this ratio is 2 is to 1. Okay. Now, for next median, BQ. Now, BG is equal to 14. GQ is equal to 7. Now, this ratio, 14 upon 7 is equal to 2 is to 1. And here third for CG. Here CG is equal to 12. RG is equal to 6. And the ratio CG upon RG, that means CG is to RG, 6 upon 12, 2 is to 1. That means here each ratio is 2 is to 1. That means we can say that the centroid, that means this point G, centroid divides each median in the ratio 2 is to 1. And from this, we have these properties of median. The medians of a triangle are congruent. Their point of congruence is called a centroid. And it is denoted by G. For all types of triangles, the location of centroid is in the interior of the triangle. The centroid divides each median in the ratio 2 is to 1. These are the properties of medians. Now see here, how to draw the median of a triangle. For that, first we have to find the midpoint of the side of a triangle. And to find the midpoint of the side of triangle, we have to draw the perpendicular bisector of that side. And you know how to draw the perpendicular bisector of the side. Now on page number 21, see one figure is given. To find the midpoint, the perpendicular bisector is drawn. That point P is the midpoint of BA, and that point P and the opposite vertex is joined, and CP is the median. So to draw the median, first we have to find the midpoint of that side. For that, you have to draw by geometrical construction perpendicular bisector of side, and you know that construction. Using that construction, you can draw the median. Now, practice it for point one, question number 7, fill in the blanks. So, figure is given here. Point G is the center of triangle ABC. Now, see here, RG is equal to 2.5. We have to find CG. We know that CG, length of CG for length of RG. This ratio is 2 upon 1. So here RG is given. Therefore, length of GC upon RG is given 2.5. So by cross multiplication we get length of GC is equal to 2.5 into 2. We get 5. So this is answer is here. Your answer is 5. Now next. First here, BG is given 6. We have to find BQ. We know that BG upon BQ, sorry, GQ is equal to this ratio is 2 is to 1. But this length is given 6. 6 upon GQ is equal to upon 1. So by cross multiplication we get here 2 into 2 multiplied by GQ is equal to 6. Therefore GQ is equal to 6 upon 2 is equal to 3. That means here BG is 6 BQ. Sorry, GQ is equal to 3. So here we have to find, here something is wrong here. Second, okay, now GQ is 3, this is 6 and 3, so here BQ is equal to 6 plus 3, we get 9, that means BG plus GQ, 6 plus 3, this is 9. Now see here, AP is given 6. Then we have to find AG and GP. Now suppose here AG is equal to 2x and PG is equal to x. Suppose this is x, this is 2x. The ratio is 2x to 1. Therefore, 2x plus x, this total length is given 6. Therefore 3x is equal to 6. Therefore x is equal to 6 upon 3 is equal to 2. That means here x means PG. And therefore 2x is equal to 2 into 2, 4. And 2x is equal to 4. That means 2x is equal to AG. Therefore AG is equal to 4. And GP is equal to 2. In this way, you solve very many examples from practice set 4.1.